Hi there, welcome to my channel. My channel is called Not Nearsighted because I absolutely refuse to be nearsighted anymore. I want to get rid of my glasses. I don't care how long it takes, I'm gonna do it. So, if you don't know me yet, my name is Nagar. I have been doing the Reduced Lens Method by Endmyopia.org for the past almost 2 years now, and I have seen tremendous results. So I used to be at minus 5.5 diopters, which you can barely see like 20 centimeters at. It was really bad. And now I'm at minus 3 diopters, which is great. And since I've started this, I have been taking measurements of my eyes. And I've recently plotted the data and it looks really good. So I really want to share it with you guys. So before I start sharing you the data, what in the world am I measuring? So I'm doing the centimeter measurements. So if you already know endmyopia.org, you already know this. But if you don't know, pretty much what I'm doing is I'm measuring my own eyesight instead of going to the optometrist. So you can do this at home. I use this measuring tape. I got it from the dollar store for about $2 or something. And I stand in front of printed text. I use my eye chart. I use the little print, like the regular printed text on my eye chart, not the big letters. So I just, because I already have my eye chart on the wall. So I use the eye chart. I just stand in front of it. And then I hold this measuring tape to where I can see just a slight bit of blur. And then I record that measurement. So I record in centimeters. And then if you take 100 divided by your centimeter measurements, then you're going to get your prescription measurement, which is so cool. So I've put on my differential glasses. These are the glasses that I currently use for near work. And now let's look at the data. So I have here the morning centimeter measurements on the y-axis. This is the centimeter measurements that I take, and I take them every, like, not every morning, obviously, but I only record the data in the morning. So it doesn't matter when I wake up in the morning, whether it's 6 a.m. or 9 a.m., I will allow my eyes to adjust a little bit to light. And then after I finish my kind of early morning routine, then I will measure my eyesight. So, and then in the x-axis, we have the date. So I've started this around summer of 2022, and we're currently at summer of 2024 right now. All right, so first thing I noticed is that there's an increasing trend. So I've already known that because my eyesight has been getting better and better, but just to see it on a plot like this, it is so satisfying. So there is an increasing trend, which is amazing. And I actually measured I took a linear fit of this, and I'll put it up on the screen, and I measured the rate that I have improved at. I don't remember it right now, but I'll put it up somewhere. Okay, next thing I notice is the fluctuation in the data. So I don't know if I'm the only one, so please let me know in the comments if you are also seeing fluctuation in your data, but my data is actually fluctuating quite a lot, but there is an increasing trend, which I'm not worried about, which makes me not worried about the fluctuation, because I know that my everyday lifestyle is not exactly the same. Like, every day is not the same. Maybe I don't always get perfect sleep. Maybe I'm not outside for the exact same amount of hours doing active focus every day. Near work habits are different. Maybe some days I have more near work, some days I have less near work. So in the next day, depending on if I have released that ciliary spasm or not, I may have still some ciliary spasm left over. So I have this fluctuation, but it's totally fine. It really just is a reminder to me that, okay, maybe what did I do the day before? What did I do the day before that? Like, what was it that I did that made me have a drop in the in the centimeter measurements? And usually there is some. I'm just going to pop up on the screen where I have switched my glasses, like where I've decreased my prescription. And usually I've been decreasing it ever since, I think, January 2022. That's when I actually got this thing together and I knew what I was doing. Before that, I had no idea what I was doing and I was kind of doing it wrong. Maybe I'll make a video on that. But I, ever since I've been doing it properly from January 2022, I've been decreasing my prescription every 3 months. Like, not even every, you're supposed to switch it every 3 to 4 months. I've been dropping it every 3 months, and that has worked for me. This last prescription, so I'm currently wearing the 3-3 in my right eye, -3.25 in my left eye. So this last prescription, I've been really delaying it, and there were so many reasons to that. So at first I was like, okay, let me wait for I'm currently a student, so I'm like, let me just wait for the school term to end and so the summer can begin, and then I can drop my prescription. And so that lasted for about like 4 months where I was wearing that prescription. And then once it got to the time to switch, there was some heat waves. We had a bunch of heat waves that came where I live, and it's been re it has not right now, but before it was really hot, and I just couldn't really sleep very well. So you can see at the very end, around June and maybe at the beginning of July, like I'll circle it somewhere on the screen here. You can see a lot of fluctuation. So I went from 34 to dropping to maybe 30, or yeah, I think I was at 30 centimeters or 28, I think. Yeah, I need to go and double check this. But I actually dropped a lot. And instead of freaking out, because I was like a little bit freaked out, it's like, what in the world is happening? And then I remembered I have not been getting good sleep. It has been really hot, and I don't have an AC. Right now I do, but I didn't have an AC before. And the windows in the new place that I'm living at are just so small that there isn't a lot of airflow coming into the room at night. So I haven't been getting good sleep during those periods of time where I had where I had like lower centimeter measurements. But then actually I haven't plotted it here. But last week, for about 2 weeks, we've been having really good weather. I've been getting much better sleep, still not perfect, but much better sleep than I was during the heat waves. And so I am actually right now, I measured 2 days where I was at 35 centimeters. So that is really good. And this morning, I went and looked at the eye chart. I didn't measure my eyesight, but I looked at the eye chart at 20 feet, and I could see the 20/20 line. So that is telling me it's time to switch my glasses. I need to drop this prescription. It's been far too long right now. We need to get to a lower prescription. And also, another sign that I've been having is that I have been getting headaches, and whenever I get headaches at the end of where it's about time to switch to a lower prescription, whenever I have these headaches, I know that it's because my prescription is way too high. Like, I have it's not like it's not even headaches, actually. It's more like my eye feels in pain. Let me know if you also feel like this, but whenever I get to a point where my prescription is really good, and it's like I'm at 20/20 and it's time to drop the prescription, I get a little bit of pain in my eyesight, in my eyeballs, and then I will decrease a prescription, and then that pain is gone. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed looking at my plot. I think it looked so cool. Let me know what you think, and I am really looking forward to decreasing my prescription again. And I'll see you next time.